Joining me this morning from Wisconsin's Chamber of Commerce, Nick Novak. Good morning, Nick. How are you?
I'm great, Meg. How are you today?
Very good, thanks. So, I was kind of going over the Wisconsin's coolest things, or I should say, coolest thing made in Wisconsin tournament, and again, a wide variety of products and companies from all over the state. I also noted, and we'll talk about that too in a bit, is that it is Manufacturing Month here in Wisconsin. October is, and so we'll address that as well. But let's start by talking, do a little refresher on the coolest thing made in Wisconsin, this contest that is hosted by WMC and Johnson Financial Group, and talk a little bit about, I don't know, I guess the camaraderie and just sort of the pride in having great products made here in Wisconsin.
Well, you're exactly right about that, Meg. We are down to the top four products competing to be named the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. This is our ninth year of doing the contest. You and I have talked so many times about the different products made in your area, in all different parts of Wisconsin. And you're right about that sense of pride. There are so many cool things that we make in Wisconsin. And then the stories behind those products, I mean, the people that make them, the hardworking Wisconsinites who go into factory floors each and every day and make products that used all around the entire world. It's just truly amazing to think about the impact that manufacturing here in Wisconsin has on our state, our the Midwest, the entire country, and the entire globe. I mean, it's really cool to think about and to know that something made right here can travel absolutely anywhere. And so we love doing the contest. We think bringing attention to the manufacturing industry that is a over $70 billion industry in Wisconsin. It is our largest economic sector, truly the driver of what keeps our economy going. When we get to celebrate Manufacturing Month every October, and when we get to, crown a winner of the coolest thing made in Wisconsin, it's just so much fun. And that's why Johnson Financial Group and WMC do it every year, because we, it helps promote an important sector, and we have a lot of fun doing it.
I'm sure that you guys track this, but maybe you don't have it top of mind, but do you track data on the percentage of manufacturers that are in the different parts of the states? I mean, because I guess I just have always thought, well, of course, this is the center of my universe, central Wisconsin. But I guess in comparison to the other parts of the state, does central Wisconsin have I always believed we had a significant number of manufacturers, maybe more than any other part of the state, or is that incorrect?
So the central Wisconsin area is certainly a huge manufacturing portion of the state of Wisconsin. But actually the most, viewed on a per capita basis, the most number of manufacturers is actually kind of in the Fox Valley area, Green Bay, down towards Sheboygan, Fond du Lac, a little bit over into like Ripon, Oshkosh, kind of just surrounding that Lake Winnebago area. There's a huge intensive amount of manufacturing that goes there. But central Wisconsin is close behind, the Milwaukee area close behind. I mean, every part of Wisconsin is absolutely, critically supported by the manufacturing industry. And that's why we can do this statewide contest, because there is not a section of Wisconsin that you can go to that we don't make something. That's what we do here in the state. We make things and we grow things. So between our agricultural industry and manufacturing, I mean, that's what drives Wisconsin and grows our economy. And so we're going to continue to, talk about the great careers, the high tech, high skill, high pay jobs that are in manufacturing. And that's one of the great things we get to do during Manufacturing Month as well.
So why is it, do you suppose, that the highest concentration of manufacturers are in the Fox Valley area, as you described?
Well, a lot of it is where folks settled, decades or even, well over a century ago. I mean, there's so many historical companies that exist in Wisconsin, many of them that were needing to be near water for their manufacturing facilities. And so, you had a lot that settled there. But again, it's really grown throughout Wisconsin. And when you look at it on a statewide level, Wisconsin is routinely the number one or number two most manufacturing intensive state in the country.
Love it.
So we go back and forth with Indiana all the time. So nobody does more manufacturing on a per capita basis for the most part than what we do here in Wisconsin.
Gosh, just a lot of entrepreneurs and independent minds and spirits. That's good to hear. So let's talk about the top four finalists for the coolest thing made in Wisconsin. Who's on the list?
So we got four products, as we've talked about. I'll run quickly through them here. From Green Bay, Wisconsin, we have a company called Metalcraft Mint Incorporated. They do military medals and insignia. They actually have created the inaugural medals for both Democrat and Republican presidential inaugurations over the last few cycles. They also have made the last two Winter Games that were held on American soil. They made the Olympic medals for those games, which is just super cool to know that those came from Wisconsin. So that's Metalcraft Mint in Green Bay. We have Jolly Good Soda, which is made by Creer Foods in Random Lake, Wisconsin. I think most people grew up drinking Jolly Good Soda. It's been around for decades. And just, I mean, they have all these different flavors, Sour Power, Blue Raspberry, you know, a lot of the more fun soda flavors that are out there. And so Jolly Good and Random Lake, they're one of our top four. We also have a company that's a relatively newer to manufacturing. They were established in 2015, Vulture Systems. They make a product called Revo, and it is something that you can connect to the tip-up for ice fishing. And it will monitor the T-bar, and so it'll send alerts if the flag goes up. It will monitor the line. So if a fish is starting to pull out the line, it can have visually flashing LEDs that tell you. So if you're sitting from a distance from the hole, you can see that. And you can even have it send alerts to your wireless device. So,
I knew it.
just making ice fishing, even easier. Now you can sit, you can sit a distance away and just wait for the fish to come get it so you can stay warm. And then our last in the top four is a name that I think everybody in the state and country and probably world know, John Deere. They have a facility in Horicon, Wisconsin, and they have their X739 Signature Series lawn tractor. So it has four-wheel steering. You can go around a 12-inch diameter tree without having to back up or reposition or anything. It's not going to tear up the grass. Has all kinds of new and fun innovations, and as they told me, they've been making these for over 60 years, and the only thing that's really the same between the model they make today and the one they made 60 years ago is that it still makes tall grass short, but everything else is totally different. So, four completely different products, just showcasing the diversity that we have here in Wisconsin's manufacturing industry, which is, again, why Johnson Financial Group and WMC do this, because we make so many things, and our top four is a reflection of that diversity.
Well, and this final round of voting starts today, right, for these top four?
Yeah. Starts today. So folks in about 8 minutes can head over to madeinwis.com and you can cast your vote once per day per device, and voting goes through Thursday, October 17th at noon.
I think it's really cool. And I mean, you don't have to be an employee, obviously, of any of these companies. You can vote. And is it just once a day that a voter can, or someone can vote for these?
So you can go once per day per device. So if you have an iPhone, you can vote on that. If you have your computer, you can vote on that. So you can get a couple votes a day if you're really getting into it. But we want to encourage people to visit maidenwist.com, learn about the top four, learn about all the products that have participated in the contest so far, well over 100. And just kind of get to know what we make here in Wisconsin. And then hopefully if you're looking to, make a career switch, or maybe you're, a young person who's looking to figure out what they want to do with their life, manufacturing is a great career path, so many economic opportunities, and it's truly rewarding to make something with your hands. So, go to maidenwist.com, cast your vote, learn a little bit more about manufacturing.
Well, maybe even if you're not such a young person like myself, I can eventually figure out what I want to do with my life too. And maybe manufacturing is it. So, very quickly, we talked about how important manufacturers are here in Wisconsin. Very important. But just quickly describe the events that you have planned for Manufacturing Month in October.
Yeah, so we've been doing all kinds of things. There's you can go to WMC.org and click on the Manufacturing Month button and check out a list of all of the businesses that are hosting open houses or doing different Manufacturing Month events throughout all of October. We're obviously hosting the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin contest. We'll be hosting our annual Business Day in Madison event next Thursday. That's where we're going to announce the winner of the Coolest Thing Made in Wisconsin. We just announced that nominations are opening for a different program we run called the Manufacturer of the Year Awards, and that's something that we do in February, but we're starting to focus on it right now to get nominations and applications in for that. So we'll be talking about that throughout the month. We'll be going to the winner to actually present them officially with the trophy and tour their facility. So we just have so many different things going on. You can head over to our social media and check out some different facts and figures and other things that we're talking about during Manufacturing Month. So it's really just a great time for us to be able to focus on what is truly our number one economic driver in Wisconsin.
Celebrating ingenuity and independence. Well, Nick Novak, thanks for joining me this morning. I appreciate it. And again, it's Made in WIS, and it's WIS.com, and then your website, WMC.org. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. Hey, give my best to Megan. Have a great day.
I will. Thanks, Meg.
Thanks. Talk to you soon. Going to a break. We'll be right back on the WSAU Wisconsin Morning News.